What if we nuked Mars? I know it seems like a question from far out of left field, but Elon Musk, head of Tesla as well as SpaceX, said in 2015 that nuking Mars with thermonuclear weapons would be a great way to heat up the planet so humans could live on it. But would this actually work? And what are the implications? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. Don't forget to like and subscribe and let us know in the comments below what topics you would like to see on this channel. Humans are likely going to set foot on Mars in our lifetime, but the average temperature on the planet is equivalent to Antarctica in the winter. That is cold as hell. Have you been to Antarctica in the wintertime? My guess is probably not. Well, just so you know, Antarctica experiences an average temperature of negative 49 degrees Celsius or negative 56.2 degrees Fahrenheit in the winter. So living on Mars would be extremely difficult. Every time you went outside, it would be a mission. That being said, humans are probably going to destroy Earth in one way or another. So maybe at some point, we are going to have to pack our bags and make Mars our home. So what is the solution here? Well, you could always warm Mars up by a process called terraforming. According to Brian Toon, professor of atmospheric and ocean sciences at the University of Colorado. He co-wrote a paper in 1991 on how to make Mars habitable, and one of those ways is using thermonuclear weapons. If we nuke Mars with thermonuclear weapons, it would basically cause climate change. But if we wanted to nuke Mars, we can't just nuke the surface. That would drastically affect the terrain on the red planet. Elon Musk proposes that you could nuke the sky over the poles of the planet every couple of seconds with fusion bombs. What this would do is somewhat create two makeshift blinking suns over the two coldest parts of Mars. Our sun is basically one gigantic fusion explosion. What this would do is inevitably warm up Mars. Eventually. Any frozen dioxide on the poles would be unlocked and would convert into a gas. You probably know this already because our own planet has a CO2 problem, but CO2 is a greenhouse gas that traps heat. If there's enough CO2 in the atmosphere, that would trap the heat on the surface of Mars, causing it to warm up. In addition to that, any locked up water on Mars would end up in the atmosphere as well. Right now, the polar ice caps on Mars contain equal parts carbon dioxide and water. Once the atmosphere becomes thick enough, the greenhouse effect would occur. For a refresher, the greenhouse effect works like this. Energy from the sun is absorbed by the planet and is then released as infrared radiation. That radiation becomes trapped because of the thick atmosphere. Gradually, the planet would then warm up, eventually so that liquid water could exist on the surface. Where there's liquid water, there can be microorganisms. It is a possibility that there are already microorganisms on Mars that could begin to reproduce once Mars warms up. It would also take a while for animals to be able to live on the surface of Mars since there's so much carbon dioxide. Plants would have to flourish on the surface to create the oxygen needed for animals. So you're probably thinking, come on, nuking a planet? There has to be some downsides to that. Well, modern thermonuclear weapons are designed to have very little fallout. If we were to nuke Mars's poles, then we would have to do it for decades upon decades. By the time the greenhouse effect kicks in, you're looking at centuries later, like 10 centuries later. The nuclear fallout probably wouldn't remain anymore. There are, however, other downsides. For example, dropping nuclear bombs on Mars could backfire. If clouds began to form on Mars, it could actually cool down the planet and make it more damp. We could end up hitting the surface and destroy Mars's terrain, and again, create radiation that could kill any Martian life that already exists there. Even if it's only bacteria, imagine destroying the only other life form that exists out there in the universe. In addition, in order to nuke Mars, you would need a lot of weapons that are way more powerful than the most powerful nuclear weapon we have, the Tsar Bomba. It has a yield of 25 megatons of TNT. Even if we did nuke Mars, it's unlikely it would warm up to be as warm and habitable as Earth. And maybe something would happen that scientists haven't thought of yet. I mean, it's not like everyone's ever nuked the poles of a planet before. How could we predict what would happen? Even computer simulations have difficulty predicting what would happen. In case you are wondering, NASA had a response to Musk's idea. They said in a statement that they were committed to promoting exploration of the solar system in a way that protects explored environments as they exist in their natural state. So, it seems like nuking Mars would be pretty much out of the question. For now. I'm Charlotte Dobre, and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you want to continue on your quest for answers, check out one of these great videos on the screen right now. Or check out our playlist, Biggest What Ifs. Make sure you click that bell so you never miss an upload. See ya!